forcing your personal to the point where I'm saying, fuck you. No disrespect, but the effect of what you call correct is breaking my neck. I know your intentions were to protect, but forcing your personal views is hurting more than helping, making me wanna reject, to the point that I say, fuck you. If I had my way, I'd jangle with your Pope and Gola style. Put him in a headlock and whisper in his ear. If your mind was a water closet, I'd sit down and show you how I feel about your religious background. Some look up to the sky for the support, and as much of a criticizing badger that I am, I agree. We all need kickstands to keep our lives up straight, but I refuse to bow down to kite skeletons. That's like me wearing around my neck the knife that stabbed my father with a picture of his corpse edged in a blade. I don't praise inanimate objects unless it's man's imagination manipulating how I see things. So while others will bow down to the cross and await their fate, I will re-ring and string these two pillars and hang glide on out of here on the next strong Armageddon wind to escape through the tailpipe of Dante's Inferno with Gypsy's luck and determination. My imagination station will keep me alive with infinite styles that will arouse the mind muscle to keep who I am on the hustle so all that evenism can be muzzled.
So all of that evenism can be muzzled.
Don't blame my disapproved behavior for not praising your savior. I follow my own prayer. I follow my own prayer. Don't blame my disapproved behavior for not praising your savior. I follow my own prayer. I follow my own prayer.
Story. There was once a white man who sold ice in a black town, and everybody bought from him cause there was no one else around. But he really didn't like it, see he had to get his money, so he was just nice enough. Now in this town there was a young man who thought if he could get paid, shoot, I could get a cut. So he started to sling his own ice and at an even lower price, and it was like he struck gold. And pretty soon his ice was being used in every household. The white man was outsold. Everyone supported except for the one old lady. So he stepped to and asked why she was being shady. He thought that maybe it was something somebody told her. But when he asked her, she said, oh baby, that white man ice is just a little colder. Ain't that nothing self-hating? To this day, black people still won't buy my tape, cause I'm not on a major label and I don't got a video. My shit's not shrink rap. You would think that we learn from our mistakes. The moral of the story is support black business before it's too late.
Late.
Support your black business before it's too late. You won't like it till it's too late.
Did you want to do it? What does it mean to meet a person you'll never meet again? Knew you once for a night on the block, never meet again. What did you learn from that woman you met on a tangent? Just by chances, you met glances, then she chose to make advances. What about that job you worked with, a jerk for a boss and a loss for luck? How did you survive employment? Who could forget that woman who passed, whispering your name under her breath? What could that have meant? Am I slower? Do people we meet come attached with signs inscribed as cement? Arrive on the scene with a clean demeanor. So clean you can see me passing like vehicle mirror. Appearing closer than you're thinking. Most compete to keep in line between comrades' culture. Except for the vulture. One man soldier, ego's a boulder. Hard to break or get to partake on any activity. And who's to you? Or criticize too yellow belly to smell the phallus. From this energy I'm ostracized. Ostracized. Head in the dirt. The reason for every attempt to step out exempt for opponent, I don't consider foe. Blow the bubble, drop the ego, drop the weasel. Before it's laughter gets too evil, abstraction acting.